heard this in a while, but here we go.
Awesome. Your booze filled me with light. Thank you so much for being here. I'm so excited to see you guys. God, this room is so much crazier with all of you sitting here. That's bonkers. My name is Dan Casey. I am the senior editor of Nerdist.com. I host a weekly show called The Dan Cam. I do. But more importantly, I'm like you. I love Power Rangers. Will you say that's an accurate description of yourself? You enjoy Power Rangers. You love Power Rangers. See, I'm repping my absolute favorites right now, Mighty Morphin. I remember back in 1993, I had to have those action figures, and I know I never looked back. And now, 23 years later, Power Rangers is still on the air. Surprises coming your way. So let's kick things off with a never before seen look at the season.
They are the Rangers.
No!
Oh, I love the reaction. They are the Rangers.
Are you serious?
The next Rangers. That's great.
And back then, and they're like, just read it. Like, oh, we haven't had time to,
yeah.
Do I do it in that other way, or do I do it like a normal person?
And so if any of you guys know about like, the casting process, very long, it's very extensive. That was probably like the 9th or 10th time that we had gone in, no exaggeration. So we had already done our screen test at that point. And right. A month goes by, I'm literally texting my mom every day. I'm like, I haven't heard anything, mom, I don't think I got it. And then a month later, my manager calls me. He's like, they want to see you one more time. I'm like, really? I thought I had to do myself by now. So I go in, they give us these scripts, and like the nerves were like 10 out of 10. Like, it was unreal. And so it was like this huge sigh of relief. Because I worked so hard, I read with all these amazing actors. Exception of James, because he was in New Zealand. he's so amazing. So it was just like, it was just an amazing, like, relief. And it was like, just this melting pot of every positive emotion you could possibly feel. It was amazing.
Well, we saw a whole bunch of emotions during that blooper reel. Did that bring back any memories? Do you have a favorite memory from being on set while filming Dino Supercharge?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes. There was a amount of Camille tripping. That was like
every day.
I think filming in New Zealand was pretty nice.
Yeah,
anybody want to talk about Wintabi, the first movie?
Oh my gosh.
Oh!
You know the one?
Yeah, talk to you about this. Just kidding, okay, I missed it.
There's a really funny blooper coming up in like the second half of the next season, so stay tuned.
There are a few that I approve that would be really
fun. So, spoiler.
Was the one episode where we were on sand dunes.
Yeah.
We were coming down the sand dunes. And it was the funnest, it was so much fun. And it was great, the weather was amazing, until it started storming.
I mean, we all took cover, so yeah.
Everyone took cover, and it was great. And we were like, yes, we're wrapped at 6 p.m. We've been up for like 16 hours, and they're like, wait.
Scattering everywhere, like it got into Dobby's mouth.
Oh man, I was in my contact.
How did that taste, bro?
It tasted like New Zealand.
Sand. Yeah, no, seriously, I still like when I take a shower, I still find sand from that day looking like.
And the first part was great because the guys looked at me and they were like,
ha! I'm pretty sure I was asleep, so I did laugh at him. I was asleep and cozy.
Yeah, you had to laugh on the tape. You spent a lot of time in the suit now, but what was it like that first time you put it on and you're like, I'm a Power Ranger? What was that like?
Hot and sweaty. The suit's very thick and it's very hot, and I was so nervous. The first time I was ever in the suit was here at Morphicon when we got out. And that was so nervous.
Yes. How was that?
And so I had all these nerves. I was worried because, like, you guys are great. I'm like, there's a lot of people in here. So I was definitely very nervous. It was like the first, big public appearance I'd ever done. So, doing it in this really thick polyester suit. So the sweat was real, but like I can say, I put blood, sweat, and tears.
Yeah. I'd say the first time I put on the suit was to film my morph, and there had been so much anticipation leading up to it, and I was just itching to put it on. It's just like, come on, guys.
Whoever I looked up to, whether it was a Power Ranger, I was a Power Ranger 2 years ago for Halloween, I was a Jedi, I was Superman, so it was like really rewarding to kind of go back to that and find that excitement that really attracted me to acting to begin with. And like, actor, that's probably the most gratifying thing that you can ever experience.
Wearing spandex.
Yeah.
As you guys know, like, I'm not a stranger to spandex, but that day, I got to put on the Blue Ranger suit 2 years ago, and the boots had my name on it, and the jacket, the suit had my name on it, and I was like, finally, this is it. I'm putting on my suit, and that was overwhelming. And I'm pretty sure as soon as I walked from the door to here and out, I was like, I just blacked out. I don't know what happened. That was great. That was great. I don't know what happened.
Oh, that's incredible. So, what would you say is the best part of being a Power Ranger?
Saying it's more than 10. We had so much fun hanging out with him, and just he was telling us all the stories of what he liked and what he had seen. And I think sharing those stories with all of you guys, that to me is pretty amazing.
Yeah, being a fan of Power Rangers as children and then getting to Don Boston himself, so like from fan to Ranger, it's just this incredible feeling because you know all those hours of watching aren't wasted because they
There's a lot of content out there in general today, and a lot of it's negative, a lot of it preaches negative things that you don't really want kids or really anyone to be focusing on, but we are all about teamwork and friendship and helping each other and finding any way to do that.
Thanks, Jim.
So, thank you, Jim.
Part about the last 2 years for me is me. Because you know, when, like, I had no idea what to expect when, you know, I was really entering this journey. But I moved to New Zealand with these amazing young people that we're going to stay in touch for the rest of our lives. I made lifelong friendships with crew members in New Zealand. And then Chipman, I gotta let shout him out. He was the best boss, showrunner that was anybody could have asked.
Saban, and he was telling us the storyline. He was like acting it out himself and just really putting emotion behind it. You knew he cared about this. You know, this isn't just a job. This is a lifestyle. This is something that means so much to him and to all of you and all of us. So,
yeah,
and it's contagious too. Because you know, anybody can force themselves to study something, but when you're really interested in it, that's when you really, you know, create the nuances that I think makes something memorable and transcendent. And I think that really is something that's true to our season. And I think, you know, I can't say enough good things about everybody that we worked with. This unreal.
Now, really quickly, before we kick things over to audience Q&A, so start thinking about your burning questions now. How would you describe the upcoming season when it returns to Nickelodeon August 20th, the second half of the season? How would you describe that in one word?
It's crazy.
Deals.
Awesome.
I guess. Awesome.
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 Yeah. Awesome. We're phenomenal. That's that.
Fantastic. So guys, let's start lining up for some audience Q&A. I'd love to take some of your questions. I believe we have some microphones lined up, so please cue orderly. No pushing, no shoving. They're taking some questions now. On the my left, your right, stage left.
All right, love it. It's like in person Twitter.
Exactly. All right, do we have someone up there with a?
I see that helpful Maddie shirt.
Then can we get her a step ladder?
I like that shirt, by the way. I have one in green. Yoshi, put this up.
What is your name and what is your question?
both Dino Charge and Super Charge.
Thank you.
That's all Chip right there.
Thank you, Chip. I want to know, like, what is, like, the best part of, like, filming a season like this?
Ooh. It's kind of cool that we go back to dinosaurs, because that's what we grew up with. I'm sure all of us grew up with dinosaurs, and it's kind of cool to be back in that realm, you know, to be, I guess, prehistoric. But it's also, like, really fun that we got to play so many different characters. Like, Chip went out on a limb, and we, you know, we had the knight, the caveman, the prince, so we just went all over the place, and he made it work. And it was a lot of fun to do.
And that's something that's tough, too, for a kids' TV show to have a character with really kind of a language barrier. Like, it's tough to pull off, but I think that it was really a cool character, and, like, you know, it definitely worked out.
Well, thanks, man.
Yeah.
You did a good job.
You did a good job, man. So thank you, man.
Thank you.
All right, thank you there. What is your name and what is your question?
My name is Noah, and my question pertains to Emil and Brennan. What do you think Shelby sees in Tyler? Like, what traits does she see in him?
What does Shelby see in Tyler?
Ooh.
Oh.
She wasn't the kid at school who was super popular or had like a ton of friends. She wasn't widely loved, she was deeply loved by this family. And Tyler was the person to bring them together. So for her, Tyler was the person to bring her to a place of belonging.
Aww.
Before you got the role of Shelby, were you a fan of the Power Rangers franchise?
Yeah, I was a fan. When I was growing up, I'd, you know, watch it. Obviously, I was a Pink Ranger for Halloween. But, you know, I never thought in a million years I would end up here.
That's good.
It is the best blessing that I could possibly ever wish for.
Yeah, especially when we all grow up watching Power Rangers.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I know you. You write to me all the time.
Thank you very much.
I have to send my
list. All right, you there. What is your name and what is your question?
My name is John, and no question. I just want to say thank you guys for everything you do. I watch it all the time. I talk about it on my channel. You guys are awesome. You're great. And you rock.
What's your channel called?
My channel?
Yeah.
Mr.
Weenie
Productions.
Well, thank you, man.
I know the guy.
Thank you. Fan base is amazing. It's always been super warm, super receptive. And it's really fun interacting and seeing what you guys, what your opinions are, what you guys think. And it really, like, it doesn't go unnoticed. We really do pay attention to it. And it's really, it's nice to hear all the praise, because, you know, it keeps us going in the dog days of the shoot, which, you know, it's a long shoot, so it's definitely nice to have such amazing fan
fans. All right.
Woo!
Thank
you, guys.
Thank
you so much.
Hey, somebody asked James a question, so we can hear his
My accent.
Hi, Mike. Hello. What's your name and what is your question? What is your favorite scene to shoot?
Wow.
Action sequences. Can't.
My favorite was the first time I got to say it's more of a time. I think it was a really, really hard day in all, but
yeah,
that was like one of the hardest days. That was the theater day. The beach. It was pretty tough just because of like how cold and it's morphe time, and I was like, today's the day.
Setting, so we literally had like probably 10 minutes to film that, and so the director was like, Yoshi, are you ready? He was like, yeah! And he was like,
ruin my whole life!
It was hilarious. It was like Baywatch meets 8-Man.
It was really cool acting with Brennan and Yoshi because of how big they are as fans of this as well. And so their passion just was non-stop the whole time. So it was obviously fun to work with everybody, but it was just cool to see their dreams come true.
And they used the show better than anyone else, too.
Yeah, exactly. So we had a lot of questions for them, obviously for Chip.
Oh yeah, we were in this room like,
yeah, they go in like, does this make sense to do this? Like,
yeah.
My personal favorite was, and I was telling Brian this, two favorite like blocks, which is like three episodes that we filmed at a time. My two favorite blocks were my origin story when I was on the farm and how I bonded with my hunter Jim saving my dog. And then the finale was really cool too. This is just so like it's so gratifying. We filmed it like a month before we left, but it was still really cool to tie it. It's gonna be epic. Check it out.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This has been one of the greatest seasons we got since Saban bought back the rights and everything. My question is, if you guys got to team up with any Ranger team or Ranger, who would it be?
Say Ninja Steel?
You're getting ahead of yourself there!
Oh!
Just a couple seconds.
Alright.
Alright.
That's it.
Hello there.
Hi. My name is John Hale from the Armored Rangers.
What's up?
That's a dope costume.
I like the color. So my question, I like behind the scenes stuff. What is your most embarrassing moment on set?
Set. I know what you mean. The opening set.
And then I start talking, and they have to fix our makeup, and I'm like, I'm so smart, guys, the makeup is so complicated. It got better from there, but that was the worst thing.
Mine's in an episode yet to come, so people can talk about it, unfortunately. Sorry. Tweet me about it.
Stay tuned.
Will they know it when they see it?
Probably. There are a lot of moments that they'll never see. But I think a lot of the best moments that were behind the scenes were the days where we were super tired in the Dino Cafe, and there was food involved, and it always ended up getting thrown.
It always ended up in somebody's
and,
face.
And, you know, we just went from mature adults to straight up third graders.
We'll do that too.
Yeah, we just play with each other and have so much fun.
hate to keep throwing Camille under the bus. Honestly, it was awesome.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for your question. Unfortunately, we only have time for one more question.
Yeah.
Don't worry, we have some really cool stuff coming up after this. It's not the end. We have some cool surprises. So
I figured since we started very, very late into this.
Yeah, you got it. Good.
So, what was probably the most hardest thing, or your least favorite episode or scene to film? The hardest thing?
The last one. They don't want to let go of each other.
Yeah. Emotion.
It's like any like hard stunt or like falling or something like that you guys had to do that you didn't really want to do.
Just the entire show in general was pretty tough.
Spoilers! Just a heads up.
Coming soon, when a dangerous energy resurfaces, the dark energy forms from pure evil. The Rangers will call on new allies.
Fly at the sword.
And new swords.
They will come with the tiny tail sword.
To take on an ancient evil.
You don't know what I'm capable of.
Brand new episodes return Saturday, August 20th.
charge. Dino, you've seen the stars. The next Power Rangers. This is Ninja Steel. Thanks for watching. See you later.